is back. Good Thursday.
It's a whole new world. We have to adapt.
Welcome back. It's the championship contenders match that Moose Holly wanted, but not the way he wanted. It's a two-on-one handicap match against The Miz and Theory.
There are perks to being a champion in WWE, which Theory is, which Miz has been multiple times. There are also additional perks to being the mentee of Mr. McMahon, which is what Theory is to this very moment. There are perks. There are high upside.
As Theory's been using that relationship with Mr. McMahon to his advantage, and what's obvious here is that Theory does not want to have to defend his
Wow.
I'm going to say Theory does not want to have to defend this United States Championship at any point, because Mustafa Ali is going to take another look at this show.
Theory should get credit for that one, Saxton. I don't know if you saw that, but it shouldn't be frowned upon. It should be celebrated. Theory gets better and better each and every week.
Each and every week.
So let's look at it again. Watch Theory in the corner. Old Moose took a one-way trip to the outside.
Very hard landing for Mustafa Ali.
Comes from what Saxton Miz started. Miz is a trendsetter. Theory is a trendsetter.
You're a follower. The Miz said it's not going to say it to you. Is that what you want to do?
Good cover. Hook in the leg. Kick out from Mustafa Ali, but starting to wear down in the center of the ring.
And again, this is what Theory wants. Theory does not want to defend the United States Championship against Ali. He's stacking the odds. Stacking up the odds. That's why he said he wants to be a handicap.
Theory is doing just fine on his own, Saxton, resting all of his weight against the down Ali.
Moose.
It's another smart decision in a series of them by the youngest United States champion in WWE history.
Remember, it was last week on Miz TV that Theory instigated the match between Miz and Mustafa Ali. A deflection again last week. Talk about stacking the deck.
Yeah, if you want to be so braggadocious, talk about how Theory, why not take on Mustafa Ali, prove your superiority?
Oh, my goodness.
Despite the odds.
Straight into the neck breaker. Shoulders down.
For the second week in a row, baby.
Oh. Theory just in time with the rescue. I appreciate that Mustafa Ali fancies himself a bit of a disruptor here in WWE. Ali wants to shake up the status quo. But there are ways to do things the right way.
What's the right way?
Not interrupting Miz TV.
Mustafa Ali had a match. He won the match.
Crushing finale. Beautiful timing, shoulders down. And a win from Amazing Theory. Three winners. The team of the United States Champion Theory. And the win.
This is beautiful. A symbiotic relationship between Miz and Theory.
It was a campaign to embarrass Mustafa Ali.
Adding insults to injury. Put on the chest.
Theory on the outside, causing just enough of a headache for Ali. For The Miz to swoop in like a true hero. And boom! Skull-crushing finale. Thanks for coming, Mustafa Ali.
It was unfair from the start.
And maybe Ali should have earned this opportunity. And of course, the selfie. Oh, this is a great selfie. Can't wait till it ends.
These two have been around to do something special. Two-on-one.
Are you implying that Mustafa Ali is not an elite-level competitor, Saxton?
Why? Mustafa Ali just the same challenge
as you for you.
Oh, look out! Ciampa from behind once again leveling Mustafa Ali just even last week.
What is this all about?
Mustafa Ali not getting the second chance he wanted. Reggie looking for the same thing earlier today.
You, out of all people, I would never think you would try and pick me. me an apology.
Dana, it was a test.
A test?
You know, like keeping you alert, you know? Okay, I'm sorry. I really want my baby back. I need my baby back. I feel empty inside.
You feel empty inside? You're empty? My waist is empty. And you, you're supposed to help me with the 24/7 test.
Please, brother.
Yes.
Trying to get at Dana Brooke.
pleasure to see you, Reggie.
You guys are beautiful together, Reggie. Fight for your woman. There you go.
I'm going to trade him in for a newer model. It's fine.
Reggie, obviously devastated, as was Becky Lynch last week, but a surprise in the middle of her devastation.
This is just the beginning. This is the beginning of the legendary Becky Lynch comeback. Nobody's going to be able to stop me. Not Bianca, not Sonya, not Liv.
Disrespect from the Empress would set Big Time Mex off, but not in the way the former Raw Women's Champion had hoped. Maybe this is Freddy Brasco.
Ladies and gentlemen, joining me now, one of the greatest athletes in WWE, former Raw Women's Champion, Big Time Becky Lynch. Becky, just last week, you returned to Monday Night Raw for the first time since WrestleMania. Asuka returned for the first time in 9 months, confronting you, and then...
You don't need to tell me what happened. I was there. Do you have any idea the kind of bravery it took for me to go out there and tell the world that I had hit rock bottom after losing my title, my world, my identity, only to have Asuka, the woman who I literally handed my championship to, come out and disrespect me when I was at my lowest point? When I left, I told her, you go be a warrior, because I'm going to go be a mother. I held up my end of the deal, but she didn't hold up hers. As soon as I came back, she ran away, and I went on the run of a lifetime. Then when she thinks I'm down on my luck, then she comes back. She's the best in comebacks, so she doesn't know what she's in for. This is my comeback story. It starts with ending Asuka.
Spring Breakin' is a live NXT special on USA, tomorrow night, 8/7 Central.